That was not very good, but well, she got up.
I got her up. And then Ray Lynn came in. I said, hey, Ray Lynn. I told her, where are you? I'm trying to clean that for her. And Brian's the first time in. With Carly. And Jesus is looking right. I can help her. Oh, thank you. She's the one who did all that.
I gave them each a bit of my stuff.
You mean each one of them? I didn't paint Ariel's because she lives here.
It's okay.
Is she okay then?
Oh, no.
I would never tell my kids.
Yeah.
I mean, like I'm supposed to be doing, but they get allowance if they have some of them, they have money in their list. I didn't give them allowance until that job. Did you give them allowance until that job?
Yeah.
You still got it?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Cool, yeah. My big $10 a week.
What?
$2 a day I have for lunch. That's what I got. Oh, it's cool. I could deal with that.
Do you have to ask for more?
No, I would usually do the yards and stuff like that, so I'd have a little bit more. But $2 a day was, you know, that was, that's fair, but that's what they gave me all through high school.
2 cents, a lot better.
Yeah.
Jesus began conversing with her and bringing her to himself. And the woman said in verse 15, let's back up to verse 14. Who will drink of the water that I will give him, Jesus said, will live and drink for him. And the water I will give him will become in him a spring of water, running up to eternal life.
Ah!
And the woman said to
him, hey!
So that I may not be thirsty, and have to come here to drink. And so Jesus has her spiritual
last one.
She's been
that's
the
number 24.
And so Jesus said to her, go get your husband.
Put my head off.
The woman answered him in verse 17, I have no husband. Jesus said to her, you're right to say I have no husband, for you've had five husbands. And the one you have now is not your husband. What you said is true. Now he knows her past. The woman said, what an understatement. Sir, I perceive that you're a prophet.
Okay,
now Jesus wasn't being cruel.
Shit.